Assalamu alaikum guys, this is the second part of physiological changes during pregnancy. In this video we will see cardiovascular changes. During pregnancy there occurs elevation of diaphragm. The heart is shifted upward, outward with slight rotation to the left. Apex beat is shifted to 4th intercostal space. Normally it is present at 5th intercostal space and 2.5 cm outside the midclavicular line. Then pulse is raised. Then there is systolic murmur in the pulmonary or apical area. Decreased blood systolic murmur occurs due to decreased blood viscosity and torsion of great vessels. Then continuous hissing murmur, it is called as mammary murmur. It is heard in the tricuspid area, left, second and third intercostal space. Then it occurs due to increased blood flow through the internal mammary vessels. Doppler echocardiogram, it shows left ventricular end diastolic diameter increased. Then left atrial and right atrial diameter is increased. Then S3. This S3 sound is heard due to rapid diastolic filling. The increased blood volume strikes the right ventricle wall. This produces the sound. Then S4 is rarely heard. Then cardiac output, it is lowest in sitting or supine position and highest in right or left lateral position and knee or chest position. Then increased cardiac output occurs due to increased blood volume and to meet the additional oxygen demand. And BP, under the influence of progesterone, it relaxes the smooth muscles. This leads to decreased systemic vascular resistance. The formula for BP is cardiac output in the systemic vascular resistance. Even though the cardiac output increases, there occurs decrease in BP. It is due to decrease in systemic vascular resistance. And venous pressure. The venous pressure in the anticuboidal vein is normal, but the femoral venous pressure increases. It occurs due to the pressure exerted by the gravid uterus on the common iliac vein. In non-pregnant women, the pressure is 8 to 10 cm of water. Then in pregnant women, in lying down position, it becomes 20 cm of water. And in standing position, it is 80 to 100 cm of water. This shows that physiological edema subsides by rest alone. Then supine hypotension syndrome. In late pregnancy, the gravid uterus exerts pressure on the inferior vena cava. As a result, it compresses it in supine position. This leads to opening of the collateral circulation through paravertebral and azygous vein. Failure of opening this collateral circulation leads to hypotension, tachycardia and syncope. Normal BP can be restored by turning the patient to lateral position. Now we will see metabolic changes. BMR is increased due to the need of the growing fetus. Protein. Positive nitrogen balance is there, that is, intake of nitrogen is more than its excretion. Breakdown of amino acid to urea is suppressed. Blood urea level falls. And amino acids are actively transported across the placenta to the fetus. And pregnancy is an anabolic state. Then carbohydrate. During pregnancy, there is need of continuous supply of glucose from the mother to the fetus. As a result, there is increased secretion of insulin. There occurs hypertrophy and hyperplasia of beta cell. Sensitivity of insulin receptor decrease. This increase in secretion of insulin and this hypertrophy and hyperplasia occurs in response to this decreased insulin sensitivity and this contra-insulin factor, that are estrogen, progesterone, human placental lactogen, cortisol, prolactin, free fatty acid, and this increased resistance to insulin. What happens? This mechanism ensures continuous supply of glucose to the fetus. What is the function of insulin? It allows the utilization of glucose. In pregnancy, there is resistance to insulin and this contra-insulin factors are also present. So this does not allow the glucose to be utilized by the mother As a result, there is increased concentration of the glucose in the blood and easy transfer of this glucose to the fetus. Maternal fast, there occurs fasting hypoglycemia and postprandial hyperglycemia and hyperinsulinemia. As maternal utilization of glucose is reduced, there is gluconeogenesis and glycogenolysis. As there is increased glucose concentration in the blood, there occurs increased glomerular filtration of glucose to exceed tubular absorption. Then glycosuria is detected in 50% of pregnant women. Now fat, 3 to 4 kg of fat is stored during pregnancy in abdominal wall, breast, hips and thigh. Plasma lipid and lipoprotein are increased due to increased estrogen, progesterone, human placental lactogen and leptins. And lipid, there occurs increased HDL and LDL, it is used for placental steroid synthesis. This hyperlipidemia is non-atherogenic. Then iron, total iron requirement is 1000 mg during whole of the pregnancy. 200 mg is lost through normal routes. Then the iron in the fetus and the placenta is permanently lost. And variable amount of iron in the expanded RBC volume is also lost during the delivery. Then saving of 300 mg of iron occurs as there is amenorrhea of 10 months. Then iron absorbed from diet and mobilized from store are inadequate to meet the demand. In spite of the fact, there is increased absorption in the pregnancy. This inevitably leads to iron deficiency state. However, placental transfer of iron from mother to fetus is maintained. There is no correlation between the hemoglobin concentration of mother and the fetus. Then systemic changes. Respiration, there is elevation of diaphragm. Breathing becomes diaphragmatic. There is hyperventilation as tidal volume has increased. Then progesterone acting on respiratory center. This acts on respiratory center. It also increases its sensitivity of the increased sensitivity of the center for carbon dioxide. Then there occurs shortness of breath. Then acid-base balance. Arterial partial pressure of CO2 is decreased and partial pressure of O2 is increased in maternal blood. As a result, there is easy transfer of oxygen to the fetus and easy removal of carbon dioxide from the fetal blood. Pregnancy is a state of respiratory alkalosis. In urinary system, there occur dilatation of ureter and the renal pelvis. Renal plasma flow increases, glomerular filtration rate increases. And ureter, it becomes atonic under the influence of progesterone. Dilatation above pelvic brim on right side, especially in primi gravida, it occurs due to dextrorotation of the uterus, pressing the ureter against pelvic brim. It also occurs due to the pressure by the right ovarian vein. Then bladder, there occurs increased frequency during 6 to 8 weeks due to increased water intake and polyuria. In late pregnancy, there occurs increased pressure from the uterus on bladder. Then alimentary system. There occurs congestion of the gums. It becomes spongy and bleeds on touch. Motility and muscle tone decreases under the influence of progesterone as it relaxes the smooth muscle. And cardiac sphincter relaxes. As a result, there occurs acidity, it is heartburn, and esophagitis can occur. Then there occurs decreased gastric secretion. It leads to delayed gastric emptying and risk for peptic ulcer decrease. Then atonicity of the bladder leads to constipation. Then diminished peristalsis leads to more absorption of food material. Then liver and gallbladder, except alkaline phosphatase or liver function tests are normal. Then marked atonicity of gallbladder with increased cholesterol level favors stone formation. And nervous system, there occurs nausea, vomiting, mental irritability and sleeplessness. And postpartum blues, psychosis, depression can develop in susceptible individual. Carpal tunnel syndrome, it is present in few women. The cause is not known, but it is seen more in the obese women. It may be because of the tunnel is too small, so edema or obesity can easily compress the tunnel. Then sensory loss over the anterolateral aspect of thigh due to the compression of the lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh. Then calcium in locomotor system. Daily requirement of calcium is 1 to 1.5 gram. Total calcium level falls, but ionized calcium level is unchanged. Then calcium absorption is doubled due to the increased vitamin D. Then calcitonin prevents osteoporosis. And serum phosphate level is unchanged. There occurs increased mobility of the pelvic joint for the easy passage of the fetus. Then center of gravity is shifts backward. This leads to lumbar lordosis. Then in women, in pregnant women, there occurs waddling gait. Here we end this part. And thank you guys for watching my lecture.